I hope you're doing well. Welcome back to another Let's Play of Fallout 3. This is now for the PC because I realized that my PC can handle Fallout 3 on maximum settings. My 7 or 8 year old PC, that is. So I decided just to kind of enjoy the little better graphics that the PC has to offer compared to, I think, the PS3 version. Okay, so I basically, I'll show you what I did with my character. I have him set with 9 intelligence, 9 agility, and 9 perception. Not too worried about strength, endurance, or luck. A little bit in charisma. I want to be able to, use the energy weapons, hire more skill points, and more action points. And small guns and sneak, so kind of like I'm not quite sure what kind of build this is, but I'm not too worried about big guns or health or being able to carry a bunch of stuff. So all right, so basically replayed the game on the PC up to this part, and I even opted to disarm bomb, and I was able to successfully use speech to find out that there's some information on Moriarty's computer about the whereabouts of my father. So, all right, and let's see my. Is the GNR building plaza, Galaxy News Radio quests. So I got to go to Galaxy News Radio, deliver Lucy's message, and that is all the way up that way, and disarm the bomb, which I don't think I can disarm the bomb just yet. I don't remember. This.
Hold on, Jonas. I need to.
Okay. All right, so let's get rid of some of the inventory
like that.
That I have. I'm also going to try to keep my karma up and not steal if I don't have to, that is. So I know I can get into his terminal at some point, but I have to wait for him to, wait for him to leave or something.
Hey, pal, what do you need?
A place called Underworld. It's a cool city down in D.C. I set off up here to find you.
Yeah, I did all this in the previous Let's Play, so let me just. Alright, so I don't want to waste too much time. Let's. Yeah, it's Jericho, and he doesn't want to join me because I'm too much of a goody two shoes with my high karma. So, let's see. Another supply shop is around here. Okay, let's see, where am I at? Right, Bill Grail's house. Armory, the restroom. Looks like I gotta turn around and go over there.
Roger. I'm Manya. The old man wandering around here is my husband, Nathan. If there's anything we can help you with, ask me. Don't ask Nathan. He'll just blabber at you about the damned enclave all day.
Got some questions about this town's history.
I can tell you just about anything you want to know, honey. Megaton's history ain't no secret.
What's this place made of?
Long ago, before the war, there used to be machines. They were like buses, but they flew through the sky, taking people anywhere they wanted to go. You didn't have to walk, you just went to the air station, bought a ticket, and took to the skies. Anywhere in the world, you just up and flew there. When the war happened, the machines started dropping from the sky. Everyone around here thinks that the bomb made the crater, but it didn't. The crater provided good cover from the dust storms, and when my daddy and the rest of the town decided to build the walls, they used what they had.
So why didn't they move the bomb?
Some of us wanted to, but the Church of Adam was just getting its start then. We needed their help to build the walls and clear the wreckage. If we'd have tried to move the bomb, they would have refused to help. Besides, a lot of people just wanted to leave it alone. It didn't seem to be hurting anything, and who knows what would happen if we messed with it.
There are a lot of parts here just for one machine.
Good eye. You're right, honey. There are. There was an air station a couple of miles from here. It had been stripped of everything except the planes. My daddy got a bunch of people together to go out there, break apart the machines, and drag back what we could use. It took them a couple of months. You can't even tell where the air station was anymore. The wasteland just took it back.
Why build the walls out of some old flying machine?
It's a hell of a lot easier than trying to find enough parts to build walls and houses from nothing. The scrap was there, why not use it? Besides, it's sturdy. It keeps the raiders and the dust storms out. Not all of us have the luck to be born in a vault, you know.
So another question. How did the town start?
Well, originally, it started as a hole in the ground. My pappy talked about how his father and the original settlers just hid in this crater. It was enough to keep them safe from the dust storms. When things cooled down and people started wandering into the wastes, some stayed behind. The wanderers started coming back here to trade their stuff. By the time my pappy was born, the town was a full-on trading center. Pappy got rich on the caravan routes and eventually convinced the others to build the walls to hold off the raiders.
Why did they build walls?
Well, the raiders, for one. Once the town got big enough, they'd wait until the traders and their guards were away. They'd come in and clean us out. Now, the super mutants, they were a whole other breed of problem. They'd kill us if they had to, but mostly they tried to drag people away, alive. So, eventually, my father did something about it. Him and a few others organized the traders and the citizens and built the walls. So we're pretty safe now. Still, I wish those Brotherhood of Steel fellers hadn't hit on such hard times. They really helped keep the wolves at bay.
So it was just a collection of traitors in the beginning?
Not at first. It was a collection of people trying to get into the vault, people worshipping the bomb, and a few other refugees. Then the traitors came. Now the caravans take care of most of the trading, but before they were set up, it was all Megaton. I worked on the caravans with my father for a while. That's how I met that worthless bag of liver spots I call a husband.
So anyone can live in Megaton?
No. Space is limited these days. You see all of these people wandering around here? They live up in the common house and aren't really citizens. Most people around here keep one eye open around strangers, but me, I can spot a raider spy at 100 meters. I'm not worried about it at all. But if having meetings and pretending to vote on things makes the others feel safer, so be it.
Alright, it's enough of the history lesson. How did you get here?
I was born here initially, just like my pappy. Oh, for a while I helped him scavenge and then later on his caravan. But traipsing around the wasteland is work for young people. After I met Nathan, I just wanted to stop moving around so much. We've been here ever since. Of course, I can't say that it's been good for Nathan's sanity.
Where did everyone else come from?
Oh, they come from all over. All over. You name it. The Stahl family grew up out east somewhere. Lucy's from some little settlement to the north. Billy doesn't really talk about where he's from. Doc Church used to live in Rivet City. Jericho, well, let's just say that men can change. I hope.
There's some charge around here.
Well, technically, no. But you can't put two people in a room together without one of them trying to govern the other. But it depends on who you ask. Lucas Sims appointed himself the sheriff. He throws anyone out who causes too much trouble. But Colin Moriarty runs just about everything else. Not much happens here that he doesn't know about or plan.
Tell me about Colin Moriarty. Tell me Lucas Sims. All right. I don't want to get stuck here too much. The dialogue. Okay. What's the word around town? I have to go down. We'll come back and maybe chat up with her a little bit later. Is that Jericho? Oh, there's Billy Creel.
Well, hot damn. Someone new. Always a pleasure. Name's Billy Creel. You call me Billy, all right? I know Megaton looks more like a boneyard than a town, but it ain't all bad. Take me and Maggie, for instance. We make do just fine. I trade the stuff I scavenge, and she helps keep me on the straight and narrow.
Sorry, it's Maggie.
Oh, sorry. I guess I got ahead of myself, huh? Maggie's 9. Sweetest little girl you'd ever care to meet. We take care of each other. I ain't never had a daughter, but if I did, I'd want her to be Maggie. I took her in when her parents got killed by raiders. That was 2 years ago. It was a pretty bad scene. Small settlement up north. I'd stopped in to trade some salvage, and the whole place had been wiped out. I found Maggie hiding under a bed in the same room where her parents had been butchered. We've been together ever since.
It's a settler. Okay. Let's see. Jericho's house. I think I need to keep going this way. Empty house. The brass lantern. The clinic. So excited to be here.
Hey, I hear you're that stray from the vault. I haven't seen one of you for years. Good to meet you. I'm Moira Brown. I run Craterside Supply. But what I really do is mostly tinkering and research. Say, I'm working on a book about the wasteland. It'd be great to have the foreword by a vault dweller. Help me out, would you?
Where's the option that says, you're annoying, can I shoot you in the face? Sure, I've got plenty to say about life in the vault. Where Where'd you get the vault suit back there? Yeah, why not?
Great. Just tell me what it's like to live underground all your life. Or to come outside for the first time. Or whatever strikes your fancy.
There's batteries down there until Dad left. This outside place is amazing. In the main room, I can't even see the ceiling. That's him. That's an ambassador from the Utopia Vault 101. How do you people live out here? I haven't found a food dispenser anywhere. It was cramped, dark, and the food sucked. Good riddance. Let's do this one.
A runaway dad, huh? I've seen plenty of them before, but none with the big 101 on their back. Good luck finding him. Maybe the armored vault suit will help you out there, huh? That'll be good for the book. In fact, want to help me with the research? I can pay you. And it'll be fun.
Sure. Come on, let's do it. I'm so excited. What's this book you're working on? Pay? What sort of pay? What sort of work?
Let's see. Dealing with radiation, testing an experimental device, and, I won't lie, it may include some reading. That sort of stuff, you know? But for all that, I can pay you with caps, meds, chems, and maybe even a few of those unique inventions, if you do a good job. Interested?
Oh, by golly, yes.
Well, it's a dangerous place out there in the wastes, right?
People it sure is.
A compilation of good advice.
You're right.
Like a wasteland survival guide. For that, I need an assistant to test my theory. I wouldn't want anyone to get hurt because of a mistake. Nobody's ever happy when that happens.
No, they're not.
No, then they just yell a lot at me. Mean, mean words.
Meanie pants. Sounds like a great idea. I can't wait to help. Okay, I guess I'll help with this survival guide. Let's do the more exciting one, because I'm so excited to help.
Good enthusiasm!
Why, thank you.
I think the first chapter will have to be about surviving day-to-day dangers.
I agree.
Things like where it is and isn't safe to find food,
right.
The dangers of radiation,
true.
And how to avoid and even profit from dangerous landmines.
Oh, exciting.
Sounds like fun, doesn't it?
Does.
What do you want to do first?
I don't know. I'm so excited. I don't know which one. Getting food doesn't sound so bad. What are you looking for? What about radiation, landmines, how about the food?
Well, food and medicine. Everyone needs them once in a while, right?
Of course.
A good place to find
You're so right.
There's an old super duper mart not far from here.
There is.
I need to know if a place like that still has any food or medicine left in it.
Okay. Alright, I'll check the super duper mart.
Oh, great! Food is most important.
It is.
You can get medicine, too.
Okay.
And if there's nothing to find, then just come back in one piece, okay?
Okay. Let's talk about collecting stuff from the super duper mart.
So, how's the scavenging been? Got the food and medicine from that super duper mart?
No. I haven't gotten around to it yet. I'll do it again. No, okay.
Oh, well, could you get on that? Thanks.
Yeah, why'd you get all evil on me? If you thought about disarm, okay. Do you sell any special? Let's see what you have for sale.
What do you need?
Alright, I want to sell all my junk here. Jumpsuit, BB gun, I don't know. Get rid of my baseball bat. Baseball glove. Clipboard, whiskey, fancy lads, snack cakes, fork, grenade, grognak, barbed, hot plate. Maybe I'll keep that. I don't need jet. That's right. I'll keep that. I don't need a pencil. Plunger, I think, is used for something. I don't need a police baton. Or baseball cap. Psycho. I'll keep the meat. I don't need scotch. I don't need a red plate, I don't think. Get rid of the shot glass. plus five. Okay. Get rid of the whiskey, the wine. I'll keep the glue. I don't know if I need a wrench or not. What does she have for me that I can buy? I think we have enough. I got rid of some stuff, so let's go on a mission. Let me just check my armor. There we go. All right, let's get out of here. I wanted to just unload all that stuff. Let's get to the. Okay, there we go. All right, let's Lucy Harith.
Ah, fellow student on the path of the wasteland. Welcome to my humble caravan. Please relax, for we are in a place of safety.
Hey, that's my gig.
A type of safety that can only be ensured by an abundance of weaponry, both wicked and awesome, all of which can be yours for the right price.
All right, let's see. I'm here to buy.
Please enjoy my selection of high.
All right, there's energy cells. All right. So let's just traipse. but I'm gonna go check it out anyway. Trying to remember what was in here that I had to fight. Springvale Elementary. Okay, lots of people hung up, butchered, and all kind of nasty. So we got some red markers on my screen. Maybe they're outside that door, I think. It's too bad he can't lean. This game. Alright. See if we go over this way. Nope. I got one over there. Let me see if I got something here with my... brightness. Up a little bit so you can also kind of see.
Oh, this is gonna be fun.
Oh, didn't see me. I didn't. I holstered my gun because I thought he was friendly, but I don't think he saw me. I wasn't even really paying attention, so. Okay. Take his pistol. There's some dogs in here. Let's see what that armor's like. Let's see. Items. Barrel. Armor. No, I don't want to use that. That's bad damage reduction. What else we got laying around here? Scavenge. press. I think that's it. Okay, I'm still hidden, so. Getting close to someone. It's hard to tell where these. These folks are. Worth selling. Let's see what else we got here. These are all empty. Okay, let's just keep going this way. I thought somewhere near, at least to an underground, like ant. Take a small destroyed book. I hear somebody close. There's nothing here. That's kind of easy. One more shot should do it. There we go. place. Sweet. There's a guy over there somewhere, I think. Nice, awesome. All right. That goes upstairs. Let's keep going. Just close this door. Desk is empty, okay. What's this? Surgical tubing. Wonder glue. It's hard to see anything. Just scanning to see if there's anything there to take in. Okay. There we go. Stuff, but it's all red infused. Desk is empty, filing cabinet is empty. Nice. Am I back at the beginning? Yes. Okay. There's one more person, but that could be upstairs. Unless there's a room I missed. This level out. Somebody's walking, but I think that's upstairs. So, do a quick save. Let's see what we got up here. Let's turn off the run. Slow down a little bit. No, you're not, because I'm going to shoot your brains out. Where'd dude go? Bam, bam, bam. Bam. One shot. Two shots. That's what I'd like to see. Eyeballs and brains. Eyeballs and brains, folks. Eyeballs and brains. What you got? I'll take that. That's good enough for me. Alright, let's... hurry up a little bit and see what we got. It's just the exit. Looks like it might be an exit. See if I can. How far away is he? He's right there. Alright, there's one there. This guy right here. They're not gonna see me. Let's see. There's that guy over there. That guy there. Let's see if I can. Okay. Looks like I'm in caution now.
Oh, this is gonna be fun.
Let's go for the head. 2, 3, 4. Good. One more shot. Nice. Alright, I'm gonna have... I like how they're all, you know, you can hear all those shots and... You know, where'd they go? There's like two or three of them, they just like run away. The dude's right there. Okay. Let's take him out. Just wait here and surprise him. There you go. Hey, guess what? Should do it. Or just one. Yeah, you're not gonna tear nothing apart. Let's just watch your eyeballs splatter. Right in the face. There we go. I like it. Alright. Let's see if I can. Nice puppy. No, don't run away. go. Puppy. Through the wall, yeah. Come here, puppy, puppy. Come here, puppy. Puppy. Wow, he took off. Okay. Alright, no worries. Let's see what this guy's got. A Chinese pistol, take that. Springvale basement key. Mining log. What else you got? Pistol, take that. Don't want that. Take the key. That works. Alright, let's see. Take a switchblade. Take a switchblade. Yeah, I'm okay. Log entry number 3. Terminal. Hit a goddamn hive of ants in the tunnel, that's right. Bastards ate 7 of our best diggers before we could lock off the way in. Need to find some way to poison them so we can keep digging and blast into that vault. If we don't get there soon, I think I'm going to end up like Popo, except it won't be the sheriff popping me. It's going to be my own men. Log entry. Oh, I'm reading them backwards. Whatever. Some of the scabs got tired of digging the tunnel and started using mines to get into the caves. Not a half bad idea. The explosions damn near knocked the building apart. We got a new window or two on the side of the building. I'm going to have some of the boys knock over a caravan for more explosives. I have to use fewer in the blasts, or some assholes from Megaton will come looking. Number one, Popo died like a bitch. He didn't have half a bad idea setting up here. We had a good thing going, picking off caravans and traders on the way into Megaton. He was stupid to try and raid the town. Dumbass deserved the bullet Sims put in his head. Anyway, there's sweeter water to be had here. That damn vault's what we should be trying to get into, not that rag-ass town. If we can get in there, ain't none of us going to want again the rest of our lives. Disconnected users suck me. As far as ammo is concerned, so no worries there. That guard dog down below, huh? Alright, let's see what we got up here. Oops, dog is annoying, though. Desk, bottle caps, works. Oops, it's empty. Desk is empty. Bunch of books right there. Dude's hung up. I guess you don't want to mess with these guys. Nothing here. Let's see anything here. These shelves. Books. This goes down. Alright. Oh, dead end. Okay. This is the way I came in when I found all these bandits. Make sure I didn't take that, take that. Don't need what I need darts for, but I'll take them anyway. And just now that goes out. Okay, so this is where I came up. Okay. Alright, so now I'm up above. There we go, what's that? Shots, let's go for four. I got plenty of ammo. One, two. How about that, buddy? Oh, what I missed. Oh, that's not good. Oh, you know, you really need to take a bath. Bippity bam. Oh, really? I missed you. Dude. once more.